When Cyrus II inherited the kingdom, the Medes were the dominant power of the Iranian plateau. But he revolted against them, captured the capital and the king, and proclaimed himself his successor. In fact, he absorbed a much bigger state than his own, and when he replaced the Median state with his own, he also inherited conflicts with the two main kingdoms at its frontiers. Lydia, in what is now the west of Turkey, and Babylon, which had freed itself from Assyrian domination and had begun an expansion of its own, known as the Neo-Babylonian Empire. Cyrus the Great was one of the greatest conquerors of the antiquity. In the following years, he conquered and annexed his two main rivals, starting with Lydia. The last king of Lydia, who was defeated by Cyrus, was called Croesus. Little is known about him, but a legend appeared, started by Greek historians, about his supposedly fabulous wealth, hence the phrase, rich as Croesus. Maybe the ancient Greeks were impressed with the size of Lydia, which was their neighbor on the other side of the Aegean Sea. In any case, Lydia was much larger than any Greek kingdom or city-state in the 6th century. But there is no solid proof that he was particularly wealthy or powerful. He was vanquished anyway in 546 BC, and the Achaemenid Empire annexed all of Anatolia. A few years later, in 540 BC, Cyrus crushed Babylon and put an end to its influence, annexing a large part of the Babylonian Empire. This is why Cyrus is praised in the Hebrew Bible for his actions in the conquest of Babylon. By taking the city, he freed the captives from the kingdom of Judah, who could return to their land, and later he authorized the reconstruction of Jerusalem, including the second temple. I told you about this in a recent story about the Ark of the Covenant. We will come back to the cultural and religious policies of the Achaemenid Empire in a moment, because in fact it administrated very different peoples with a variety of cultures, languages and religions, and did it with quite a lot of toleration and autonomy in that regard given to its provinces. Cyrus lived for conquest, and after Babylon he turned to the east, expanding into Central Asia. He died on one of these expeditions in 530 BC, having conquered in 20 years the largest empire the world had ever seen. He was succeeded by his son, Cambyses II, who continued conquests and added Egypt to the empire. The days when Egypt was a Middle Eastern power were long gone at this point. Egypt had already been subjugated by the Assyrians before, but it was still a major conquest for the younger Achaemenid Empire because it had a large population and was still relatively wealthy. After Cambyses II began the golden age of the Persian Empire under Darius I, the third ruler of the empire, who stayed on the throne for 36 years. Darius kept expanding, but more importantly, he consolidated the largest state in the world by developing the administration, organizing provinces, and building a new capital, Persepolis. It is also under his reign that Greco-Persian wars began. So let's take a look at all of this.